Okay, so far we learn about properties of differential equation and qualitative properties, but we really didn't learn how to solve differential equation. And we have lots of methods solving differential equations, then we are going to learn them from now on. Okay, but the thing is that we do not have a one universal method of solving a given any differential equation. So we have to, depending on the differential equation that you have, you have to pick a method. One method that we are going to learn today is separation of variables. Really, at this level, you can only use separation of variables for first order, first degree differential equation. So let's write it dy over dx is equal to a function. Okay, so first order differential equation, that's just a simple expression of a first order differential equation. Now, not only we can only solve first order differential equations by separation of variables method, but they have to be separable differential equation. Now, what does it mean to be separable? Let me give an idea. So separation of variables, idea is, for example, if you have a differential equation dy over dx is equal to xy, what you want to do is you want to take all the dependent variables into the left hand side and the independent variables to the right hand side. You want to isolate them. Okay, that is why we call it separation of variables. So let's divide and take y to the left. Let's take dx to the right. You can see variables are separated. But now think about this. Can you separate variables nicely and clearly, just like I did in every differential equation? No, right? You cannot. For example, if you have a differential equation where instead of x times y, you have x plus y. Now tell me a way to isolate y on the left and x on the right. The only way we can take this y to the left is by subtraction, right? So dy over dx minus y is equal to x. Now how are you going to take that dx, just that dx, onto the right hand side just so that you only have y terms in the left? Well, try to do it. You cannot do it. Unless you violate algebraical mathematical rules. So that's a problem. So this differential equation, we say it's not separable because you are not able to separate the variables clean and cut. Okay, so that's not the precise definition of separable differential equation. Now, you cannot separate variables cleanly here because of who? Tell me. Is it because of x, y, or something? It's because of plus, right? This versus x times y, we were able to nicely separate variables through division. But this addition messed up everything. So, differential equation is said to be separable if your right-hand side is a multiple or a product of just a function of x times just a function of y, g times h. So here you can see g is x, h is y. So it's a product of two independent functions of just a function of x and just a function of y. But here x plus y, is it a product of function of x and y? No, so it's not separable. Okay, so let's see some examples. Here, dy over dx is equal to xy plus xy square. Now here, is it separable? Well, you might argue, well, you have addition here, right away it's not separable. No, don't judge too quickly, okay? Try to do some algebra and try to make function of x isolated and function of y isolated, or a product of two function of x and y. What can we do here? Let me show you a trick. We can factor out x. If we factor out x, we get x times y plus y square. Now, is this separable? Definitely, because we have a product of just a function of x times just a function of y. So you can nicely take that all the y terms through division to the left, take dx to the right, cross multiplication, then you are separated. Okay, so you can do some little bit of algebra to make your differential equation separable. Okay, all right, so let's look at another example. So we have an interesting example. Dy over dx is y square x e to the 3x plus 4y. It seems to be like it's too complicated and you wanna, you know, say like not separable. No, here we have y square and x, they are separable, right? Y square times x, I can quickly take that y square to the left by division. But how about this term? Well, we can do some algebra. We can break this exponent and write e to the 3x and times e to the 4x. Addition on the exponent is the multiplication on base, right? Now is it, it's 4y. Now is this separable? Well, yes, right? You can take, this is a product of all four functions. So you can use divisions easily. Y square and e to the 4y and keep x and e to the 3x and dx. Take dx to the right. So it is separable, right? It's a product of just a function of x and just a function of y. Okay, so it is a separable differential equation. Let me quickly show you another one. Dy over dx is equal to sine y. Now is this separable? You would say there's no function of x, but doesn't matter. Isn't that make our life so much easy? We can just take sine y to the left and just take dx to the right. Here, all the variables are separated without violating algebraical mathematical rules. Okay, so that is the definition of separable differential equations. In next video, we will learn why we can do the separations just like that. And then we will learn how to solve a full problem by using separation of variables. Okay, all right. So thank you for watching this video. Bye bye.